Hello, my name is Victor Bowden, and this is Chapter 18, The Rise of Russia. My group members are Victor Bowden, Nolan Anderson, and Christian Nisus. Russia was a very isolated country, rarely trading with its neighbors. They defended against the Tatars, which were the Mongols. They didn't like Western civilization, and differed greatly from other civilizations. Russian tax collectors borrowed ideas from the Mongols, and later became the political leaders of Russia. Once Russia was free of Mongol control, Ivan III seized control. Mongols did not influence the Russians because they did not want to influence their culture, only gain tribute from the land. Ivan III, aka Ivan the Great, believed Russia was a third Rome. Ivan IV, or Ivan the Terrible, expanded Russia and earned his name by killing Russian nobles called boyars. Ivan III and Ivan IV both pushed peasants called Cossacks to migrate to newly gained territories. The Cossacks allowed Russia to develop even further. As a whole, Russia was culturally diverse.
Early czars were careful with their interactions with the West. Culturally, the Russians were disadvantaged because of their contacts with the Mongols. Russia combined their culture with the West to create a strange amalgam of culture. Russia grew close to the West and relied on their economy. Boyars claimed the throne after the death of Ivan the Great. Russia was very large, but relied on agriculture. Peter the Great added many policies to the Russian government. He imitated Western culture and expanded on the size of the empire. Peter the Great traveled incognito. He went to the West multiple times to essentially steal their stuff and their methods to make Russia great again. Peter was intense and was willing to kill democracy in order to get his way. He constantly freed the government from aristocrats by bringing in outside politicians. He created a very large military and a very secret police to monitor his people. These kinds of secret police, like the KGB, lasted until the late 90s. He would constantly attack other European countries with very little success. Peter utilized Western principles and revamped the world of St. Petersburg, the new capital of Russia. Peter's ministers created a system of laws and fixed the tax system for the citizens. It was a custom in upper-class marriages for the father of the bride to pass a whip to the groom. Peter abolished this practice. Western influences forced the boyars to take on Western appearances. Christmas trees originally came from Germany, or at the time, Prussia. Westernization did not really affect the peasants' status, though they were very triggered when he tried to change their traditions. After Peter the Great died, weak rulers followed. Catherine the Great ascended to the throne and vigorously defended her right to monarchy. Peter III did have quite a few mental issues. Eventually, she may have been involved in the death of her own husband. She ruled with an iron fist and sometimes did not appeal to the populace. Landlords were given much power under Catherine the Great. People who attempted to conflict her were subject to torture and question. Her explorers went as far as Northern California. The partition of Poland, which was the agreement between Russia, Prussia, which is now Germany, and Austria, introduced new cultural inventions.
Serfdom, the life of East Europe's masses. During this time of the Russian era, serfs had less and less power over their lands. Overall, the serfs of this era became almost like slaves with little to no rights. Ding! Trade and economic dependence in Russia. Merchant groups popped up, but most of the population remained rural. Russia's economic system helped with its expansion, which was the goal of many of the Russian leaders. Russia's agricultural production was lacking because they only used traditional means to farm and cultivate. Social unrest in Russia. During this era of Russian time, many people rebelled and were dissatisfied with the current rulers of the time. The Pushchev rebellion was especially strong, though he was later captured and killed.
Russia's emergence as a key player in Eurasia was an important change in Russian dynamic. Russia transitioned from a rural landscape to a civilization to be reckoned with. Like my guns.
Now it's time for the not-so-open letter. Look at this. Random book that has nothing to do with what I'm about to say. Dear Ivan the Terrible, why do you have to be dat boy and kill all dem boyars? Could have worked out if only you were like their predecessor, Ivan the Great. And sincerely, everyone working on this video.
Now, it's time for a recap on what we've learned so far. As a recap, the rise of Russian civilization brought a force to be reckoned with to the table. Its czars, or rulers, like Ivan the Great, Ivan the Terrible, and Catherine the Great, each took their own initiative when ruling over a vast civilization. They each made decisions that advanced or hindered their society, but they all remained out of the reach of the Mongols, which were known to them as the Tatars. This led to a separate Russian strain of culture into the Russia we know today.
Romanov done. Well, okay.
No, we're so close!
Took power afterwards!
He traveled
incognito!
Just don't cut it, I can edit it out. Peter the Drape.
Peter the Grape. Alexander the Grape.
Yes.
Otterfox. Intense.
One. Go.
During this era of Russian time. Oh, crap. During this era of Russian time.
We can edit it out
beep.
Later.
Beep. Press stop.
No, I'm not going to.
Leave this for blooper. Just press stop.
No.
Just keep on going.